Okay, in this video, we will take a look on the Amazon Seller app. Everything you need to know about the app, you will learn on this video. Okay, let's take a look. This is the Seller app main screen. So if you see, you have all the options that we will explore on this video. So if you click first on this icon here, which is to open the menu, you can see that we have home inventory. So you can basically manage all your inventory from here. You can search for product, compare the prices, and we will do this in a second. You can access your favorite and the history of all the scans that you did with this app on the past. Also, you can see if you have any communication from Amazon, any emails or stuff like that. You can access the help for the app, and you can contact Amazon on this area here. The settings, this is really important, guys, because in here you can change the settings to shape it and to configure it exactly for what you need, and I'll show you how. So if you click first on search favorites and history, you can see here you have two tabs, the favorites and the history. So on the history, you basically can see all the product that you scanned on the past. It will hold all the products for you. So if you want to take a look on something you scanned in the past, all you need to do is come here and click the right product. So if we go back to the menu and you click on settings, and this is really important, you see here you have the settings for push notification, product search, about the app, and legal, right? It's showing the US here because I'm registered seller on the US Amazon. If we click on product search, the options that we have now is new, used, collectible, and refurbished. So basically in here I'm saying to the app, when I scan something, you need to show me the product, the price for the product as new and as used, okay? If you are going to Goodwill, for example, and you will scan a lot of used books, I recommend you to come here and uncheck the new. So the app will show you only the used condition. So it will be more quickly and more easily to you for you to identify the price. On this case, default fulfillment channel, we select the Amazon Fulfill. Why? Because we are FBA sellers, and this is the best option to select in here. If we scroll down, you can see the full low price is, we select the used FBA low price. So what's this? Every product may have FBA sellers and also sellers that are non-FBA, that we will call regular sellers, okay? So if you are a regular seller, you need to select this option because regular sellers, sometimes they have a lower price on the product, and the FBA sellers, they have a little bit higher price. So what's the advantage for the Amazon customer to pay a little bit more for this instead of buying for these guys? The difference is that the FBA, that we are FBAs, we send all the products to the Amazon warehouse. So basically, when the customer buys something, the Amazon warehouse ship directly to the customer house the product really fast, and most of the time is free shipping. Because if the customer is a prime customer, they won't pay anything for the shipping. And also, they will get a two-day free shipping. So that's why we want the app to pick up the lowest FBA price and show us exactly what will be the profit for the product we are scanning, okay? So next, we have the shipping to customer and shipping to Amazon. In this case, guys, Amazon have different warehouses around the country, right? So for me, I am located on Florida. My average per pound to send to Amazon is 40 cents of dollar. So basically, if I this may change. Usually, if I have a 50-pound box full of books, I pay around $12. And sometimes, if selling only one book, my profit is $12. So all the other books are almost shipping for free to Amazon. So you will, for now, you can set this to 40 cents. But you will, when you ship your first box to Amazon, you will have a better idea, because this depends of your location. So you will have a better idea what your cost to ship to Amazon is. Okay, so let's go back to the main screen of the app and click on this icon here, which is a barcode, so we can start scanning. So you will see on your phone something like this. Basically, all you need to do is put the barcode on the center of the screen, and the system, the app, will automatically search this barcode on the Amazon catalog, and it will show you the product on your phone. So it's something like this, okay? So what do we have here? We have the product name, we have the qualifications, right? The feedback for the customers. And this is really important, number 86 in book. This means that the book, this specific book, is on the ranking 86 on the category of books, okay? My suggestion is to scan and buy and sell books that are lower than a million in here. So if you see the category is lower than a million, it will be good to sell. Sometimes you can buy books that are higher than a million, but it may take a little bit longer to sell on Amazon because not a lot of customers are looking for that book. That's why the ranking is so high, because it's not selling that much. This case, for example, Amazon have like 20 or 30 million books on the catalog, right? This is 86, so this book is selling really well on Amazon, okay? So this is a hot sell. So if we have a picture of the book, so you can make sure it's the right book. In here, guys, we have two tabs. We have new and used, right? Remember on the settings that we have the options to show both. So that's why it's showing both. If we select also collectible, it will show another tab here with different price information for every tab, okay? So in the new category, we see that, let's take a look on this first. We have the FBA offers. This means how many FBA sellers are selling this specific product, okay? So we see that two people are selling this product as FBA for $13. And also we see new offer. These are the regular sellers, the sellers that they are not FBA, and they ship from home. And they almost all the time have lower prices than FBA. And again, why the customers want to pay $2 more in here and not getting this one? It's just because this is FBA, and this is selling and shipping by Amazon, free shipping and directly from the Amazon warehouse. So that means they trust on Amazon, and they are sure they will receive their book in time, okay? With these guys, you don't know what to expect. Some sellers are good, but most of them, on my experience, I had some difficulties buying from sellers that are non-FBA, right? So this is the deal. We have the lowest price on FBA is $13. So we have the $13 minus the fees of FBA. So Amazon, for every sale, they charge you a fee, and we will take a deep look on this later on the course, okay? So for this case, you sell for 13, Amazon fees are 487, so your net profit, is 813. So if you pay like $1-$2 on this book, your profit will be 813 minus the $2 that you pay on the book. So it's a good deal. So what is this Amazon here? What this means? This is actually means that Amazon themselves are selling this book, because Amazon, they have product that they sell themselves to. And also they have people like me, like you, that are Amazon FBA, and they have people that are selling also that are regular sellers, okay? But in this case, guys, this is really important, because you see here that these guys are selling for 13, but the Amazon is selling for $11.88. So why the customer will pay more if they can get it for $11.88, you know? So this is not a good book for you to buy. So if you are in Goodwill or anywhere scanning books and you want to sell it on here, the only suggestion I give you is to sell lower than $11.88, so you can have a competitive price against Amazon. You know, in this case, nobody will purchase these because Amazon is selling cheaper. Okay, so let's take a look on the used category. Here you see that Amazon is not selling this as used, so that's great. So I actually purchased this book on Goodwill for 25 cents. Okay, so I have here 41 sellers, FBA sellers, selling at $9.95, and actually the lowest price is $9.95. That doesn't mean that everybody is selling at this price. Most of these people are selling at a higher price, right? But the lowest price on this group is $9.95. So the system gets this price in here to do the calculation. So that means if I can sell to the lowest price, or even I can reduce this for 1 or 2 cents, so I'll be the lowest price. So when somebody wants to buy here, they will see me as a lower price. So if I sell a $9.95, Amazon will charge me $4.41 on fees, and my net profit will be $5.54. Okay, and I pay 25 cents. So if I get like 10 of these kind of books, I already have $50, you know, and it's really easy to get 10 of these. Okay, let's go next. This is another example, and you see here the name again, and this is the ranking. And this is important, guys. So this is still good because it's under a million and it's not very high. So this is a good book to sell. And I got this on Goodwill also for 25 cents. And you see that 6 people are selling this. And the lowest price of this, well, let's go back here. The lowest price of these 6 people is $7.50. And Amazon is not selling this as used. And also, I am competing with other 59 people, but I have more advantages, you know, because I am an FBA seller. So my profits here will be $3.54. Next example, the ranking here is even better because it's 24,000. That's great. I pay 25 cents on these books again. Amazon is not selling these, but I have 3 people, and the lowest price here on this group is $9.99. Okay, and also I have 59, so I have advantage over these 59 regular sellers that are non-FBA, okay? So my profit will be here $5.57, and again, I pay 25 cents. This is a great example. Let me tell you why. You see here the ranking is over 3 million. So this is really high ranking, and that means that this is not selling very well. I mean, the sales for this book are really low. That's why it's so high. The lower the ranking, the better, the more it's selling, okay? So, this is a book for kids. And I actually scanned this also at Goodwill, and it was for 25 cents. And it's saying here that I can earn $8.95, okay? So, basically, I have 2 FBA sellers, $13.96. This is my profit. But again, I can purchase these and send to Amazon, but it may take a long time to sell because it's over 3 million. Not everybody is looking for this book, okay? This is another great example. Why? This is a book that is on a good ranking because it's lower than a million. But look this, Amazon is not selling this as used, but I have 62 people and the lower price on FBA is 99 cents, okay? But the problem is that Amazon fees are $3.34. So if I charge 99 cents and I need to pay to Amazon $3.34, I have a loss here of $2.35. So if you scan this book and you see a minus $2.35 here or a negative amount, that means it's not a good deal for you because for some reason people are selling really cheap here. Probably these sellers got it for free or something like that. I am not sure why they are selling so low, because they will have loss here, okay? So don't get this book if you scan this. This example, this is an actual book I purchased at Goodwill. It was new and I pay 50 cents, okay? And look this, Amazon is not selling this book themselves. And there is one other seller selling for $49.95, okay? So if I place my offer as $48, for example, I'll be the lowest price here as Amazon FBA. And my profits will be around $38.45. and I pay 50 cents on this book. So this is a great example of the power of selling books on Amazon. If we click on this area here, it will open an explanation for the fees, for the Amazon fees, okay? So we see here the price is $49.95. The Amazon FBA fees are $11.50 for this price, okay? My cost to ship this book from my house to Amazon is $1.32. How the system knows this? Because I put the 40 cents here on the settings. Do you remember that we set this before? Okay. And also the system knows what's the weight of the book. So they are able to calculate the estimate of the shipping costs for me. Okay. So basically, because I pay 50 cents here, I can enter this price. My profit will be around 36 and something. Okay. So it's a great profit. Also, if I click on this area here, we can expand and see what Amazon is charging us. So the referral fee is usually 15% for books. And don't worry about this now, because we'll have a video on the later on the course explaining everything about the Amazon fees, okay? So, but let me show you really quick what's going on. So it's 15% of the price, the referral fee. Variable closing is always 135 for books. Order handling, zero. Weight handling, depending on the way, they charge you a little bit. So it's this, pick and pack, 102. So the total is 1150. And again, this is my cost to ship to Amazon. So basically, guys, my suggestion is to scan books, scan any products that you have, and especially for books, if the profit is more than $2, I recommend you to buy the book. Everything depends of the ranking and how many sellers there are on the system selling as FBA. But if the ranking is lower than a million, and your profit is higher than $2 or $3, it's a good deal. So get the book, because if you have 10 of these, it's already $20, $30, $50 that you are earning as Amazon seller. Okay, so basically take a look at the profit, scan lots of books, and everything that is up higher than $2, I recommend you to take it. I mean, you can, with when you are having more and more experience, you can have your own decisions, and you can have your own numbers. So depending of how much you want to risk, if you want to risk a little bit more, you can get lower profit. I mean, you can buy the books that are lower profit. So if you scam something and it's $2, $3, or $1.50, and you decide, okay, I'll get for $1.50 is enough for me, I'll get a lot of books. So it's your decision. But for the beginning, you can get anything and everything that is more than $2 or $3. That will be perfect. Okay? So go there and scan books.